Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Steve with the Crestview Avalanche Center. We're up here on a south-southeast facing slope near treeline, almost 12,000 feet. And we're checking on our persistent slab up here. We haven't seen too much activity on these aspects, so we're trying to verify whether or not things are healing and getting better. We are seeing a good bit of rounding in the snowpack, which means we're gaining a little bit of strength. This is mostly due to some warmer temperatures in the snowpack that we've also verified by measuring the temperatures. We've just cut an extended column test, and we're gonna give it some taps and see if we get any failures on this. Maybe we will, maybe we won't. All right, so we didn't get any results out of this test. The column held tight. Now keep in mind, this is just one spot. We never want to base all of our decisions off of one snow pit. That's why Zach and I are going to try to keep doing snow pits all the way around this south and west facing terrain, all the way back towards town, and see what we get.
We are now on a west aspect at about 11,900 feet near treeline. We have about 100 centimeters of snowpack, up to a one-finger slab on top of our weak layer, which is rounding, but still appears quite weak. So we're going to do another ECT just to test out the strength of that weak layer. As you can see, was able to pry out that slab, but with a lot of extra effort.
Okay, we're back, this time on a southeast facing slope, just over 12,000 feet, right at treeline. We've only got about 60 centimeters of snow here. Definitely an absence of older October snow here. It's down to about 4 centimeters now. That's sort of these faceted crystals that have also turned into a sort of a sun crust down in there. So they got kind of baked out in this place, and it didn't have a lot of older snow. Pretty well consolidated mid-pack in here. One finger going into 4 finger. Up at the top, we've got a new sun crust, and on top of that, we've got some surface faceting and surface hoar going on. This sun today, maybe the winds tonight, will help knock that stuff down. But if we have those small weak layers on top of this crust, that could be a problem in the future. Since we've got this column dug out, we're gonna go ahead and whack on it and see if we can get any results out of this pit here. Yeah, so again, we've got a pretty well consolidated mid-pack here, but not much of a weak layer on the bottom in this specific location. So if you can find these areas that are missing that older October snow, these can be the more stable snowpacks that we're looking for.
We're back on a west aspect at about 12,000 feet here. We found a little terrain feature that's got a little bit of a slab resting on some really, really weak layers. Kind of sandwiched in between the slab and that old October firm snow. So bit of a sliding surface here, potentially. Weak snow with the slab on top. So we're gonna do another ECT and see if we can get any results, see how sensitive that weak layer is. ECTX, no results. I'm going to kind of wail on this a little bit more and see if we can get any kind of failure. So we got a break there in that weak snow. However, it didn't propagate across the column and didn't break that slab loose. So again, here it's about a 4-finger slab. If you were to find a little thicker slab, which you might near and above treeline, it's not the best looking structure. But it seems like those... That weak layer is trying to heal a little bit.